Somebody asked me the two main questions of utilitarianism, and it's using the Socratic method to poke holes in your philosophy, which is great. And the two questions are thusly. If a train was heading for a group of five people and would kill them, and you had the power to put the train onto another track, which had just one person on it, would you do it? And I would say yes, in that case. Yes, I would. I'm not a utilitarian, but just seems sensible, doesn't it, that one? And the second question is, if you were on top of a bridge and a train was coming towards you, and there were five people underneath it, which would be killed, and there was a fat woman walking by, and I had the ability to chuck the fat woman in front of the train to stop the train and save the five people, would I do it? Well, it's no different to the switch. So, theoretically, yes, but personally, I don't think I would have the split-second judgment and the strength to lift a fat woman and push her over the railings. And I don't think I'd be able to do it, like, in real life. But theoretically, yes, especially since fat people, they're a drain on universal healthcare. Favourite YouTube vlogger to watch? I don't know. I think probably either Wheezy Waiter, though I don't watch his videos anymore. Vlogbrothers, obviously, I hold quite high regard. Or there's this philosopher called Stefan Molyneux who has a channel called Stefbot that I watch. And I really enjoy his videos and his interviews with various other people of similar mindset to him. If you could have lunch with anyone, dead, alive, fictional or real, who would you dine with? Ooh, don't know. Probably David Cameron, current Prime Minister of the UK. Just for the chance to, you know, have my voice heard, I think. Always a good idea. If you were invited to do a truth or fail video, what would you do it about? Well, probably quirky scientists. People like Richard Feynman, Einstein, people like that. They're really interesting as people. So yeah, probably people like that. Is there a big YouTuber you really wish you could be friends with? Who is it? Surely everybody has one of two answers to this. Surely. Everybody either says Shay Carl or Toby Turner. And mine would be Toby Turner, because he just seems like the most affable man in existence. So yeah, probably Toby Turner. Do you think there's a significant difference in safety for making friends via YouTube rather than other internet means because of the video and vlogging aspect? Well, yes, but I think that the kind of safety dangers of making friends over the internet is somewhat overstated, because it harkens back to the old days of the internet where people, they wouldn't even let you, don't even tell them your real name. Like, I had to use the name Chris Green, I used to use on my Neopets account when I was 12, just because my family didn't want me using my actual name. So back in the early days of the internet, everybody was really, really concerned about this, but people are people, aren't they? And you're going to find predatory people wherever you go, so I'm not really concerned about safety so much. Celebrity crush? Kate Beaton, the artist Parker Vagrant. Any guilty pleasures? Yes. A lot. Christa Berg, musically, is my musical guilty pleasure. Oh, I love a bit of Christa Berg. And, like, food-wise, probably I get this bag of incredibly cheap sweets every week, and they're called Midget Gems, and you get them from Tesco's. And they're only about 30p, and it's like a, I don't know, 200 gram bag or something. But, dear me, oh, have mercy. If you could, would you rather travel back in time or into the future, and why? Probably into the future, almost definitely. Like, it depends whether I can come back or not. Because if I can come back, I would choose the future, but it would be far into the future, like 3,000 years into the future or so. If I can't come back, then probably just some ways into the future, like 100 years or so, where I know that there probably hasn't been some crazy apocalyptic event or something. Like, we're probably still sort of trootling along in a similar fashion to how we are now. Though obviously, you know, we've got bionic eyes and stuff. What do you study? I study physics. What is one place in the world you want to visit more than any other? Pretty much anywhere that I can see the Northern Lights, I think. Like, my old answers used to be the Valley of the Kings and the Panama Canal were my two big ones that I've never been to and I'd quite like to see. and Dubai as well, and Hong Kong. But probably the Northern Lights trumps all of those. So yeah, anywhere kind of really high up north, and maybe Svalbard Island or something.